This Shotcut Vintage Effect tutorial shows you how to create the effect you see on the screen right now. So let's get started.
Here we are in a new project, and into the playlist I have dragged a clip. I'm going to move that clip into the timeline. This is the clip I'll be working on to demonstrate exactly how to apply the filters and make your video look vintage or old fashioned. So the first thing we want to do is come up to filters and then add. And then if you search for old, you're going to see a few different filters here, all beginning with old, and they're all old film filters. Now you can play around with these, or we'll go through them one by one, demonstrating exactly what they'll do. So the first one, dust, just to demonstrate, if I make the size and the amount a lot bigger, you can see that as you play the video, you get lots of weird kind of squiggles over the screen. When they're sized quite small, let's say 2%, and you play them, it kind of gives the effect that it's got scratches over the screen. If I also lower the amount, then that becomes much more realistic. Let's play through once more. And now you can see every now and then there's a little squiggle on the screen that actually looks like it's playing from a projector or a film reel. If we add another filter and go to old and we add grain, then as you can see, it's quite pixelated and grainy as we play through the video. Now for me, that's a little bit too much, so I like to take down the noise slightly, and also the brightness has been taken down to 83 when the default is 100. So I'm actually going to change that back to 100 because I don't want the brightness to be changed on my video clip. Let's just play that through. And that gives you a small grain with the flicks on top.
If you are getting value from this video, then hit that subscribe button and turn on notifications.
Now, if we add the next filter, type in old and then go to projector. There's quite a lot of settings here. Let's just play through and show you exactly what that does. So now when you're playing, you can see that the image kind of flickers, which gives that kind of projector effect. I'm actually going to leave these default settings because I quite like that effect. However, you're welcome to change them and play around with them as you see fit. Now, these are the main three filters you want on your project to create that kind of effect. On top of that, you can also add small scratches. If you type in old on the search filter and go to the old film scratches, you can also add some scratches. It doesn't look that obvious on the screen, but they are on there. A different video will show that in a much better way. And the last filter, go back to old one last time and select Technocolor. Instantly, as you apply that, you can see that the colors are kind of more stark. So as you play through, and that's more or less how a projector would render the image on the screen. Now they are all of the old film filters. And as you can see, it gives a pretty good effect. The only extra thing that you may want to do is add a black and white filter, which I show you in this video that's on the screen right now. Please consider liking and subscribing, and I'll see you in the next video.